Taylor Swift is continuing to open up about her ongoing battle with Scooter Braun and Scott Borchetta to control her master recordings and why she decided to speak out about it in the first place. Hey everyone, it's Susan Morad here with Clevver News, and Taylor Swift was just honoured by Billboard magazine as the Woman of the Decade. This is similar to the honour Taylor received at the American Music Awards as the Artist of the Decade, and I truly can't think of anyone more deserving of this recognition. Since the decade started in 2010, Taylor has released 5 albums, including Speak Now in 2010, Red in 2012, 1989 in 2014, Reputation in 2017, and of course Lover earlier this year. And in this decade, she's broken stadium tour records, won 10 Grammys, including 2 albums of the year for Fearless and 1989, and stood up for other artists, among countless of other impressive accomplishments. So it's no surprise that Taylor received this honour from Billboard, and how fitting that it comes the week of her birthday, which is such a special gift. Well, Taylor sat down with Billboard and discussed the 2010s as a whole and where she's at now. She opened up about her public fight with her old record label Big Machine and her ongoing issues with Scott Borchetta and Scooter Braun. We all know that Taylor has been very public and open with her fans about her struggles with Scott and Scooter. So much so that she's taken to social media to speak out when she accused them of bullying her, not giving her the chances to buy her masters back, and not allowing her to perform her music. Clearly, what Taylor has done is starting to work, because she was allowed to perform her music at the AMAs and people are having a conversation about the music industry. Taylor talked about how she is unsatisfied with the established norms of the music industry. She said, quote, "We need to think about how we handle master recordings, because this isn't it. I spent 10 years of my life trying rigorously to purchase my masters outright and was then denied that opportunity, and I just don't want that to happen to another artist if I can help it." And Taylor talked about wanting to buy her masters back and not being able to, despite what Big Machine label has claimed. Taylor said she was offered the chance to earn back the masters to one of her albums for each new album she turned in if she re-signed with Big Machine. Scott disputed this, saying she had the opportunity to acquire her masters in exchange for re-signing with the label for a length of time, which we later found out was 10 years more. Obviously, neither of these worked for Taylor when it came to getting her masters back. She said, quote, "God, I would have paid so much for them. Anything to own my work that was an actual sale option, but it wasn't given to me." And as we all know, in response, Taylor has said that she plans on re-recording and re-releasing her old songs as soon as she contractually is allowed to, so she can have full control over her music.
Yeah, that's true, and it's something that I'm very excited about doing, because my contract says that starting November 2020, so next year, I can record albums 1 through 5 all over again.
And Taylor revealed to Billboard why she plans on re-recording her music. She said, quote, "The reason I'm re-recording my music next year is because I do want my music to live on. I do want it to be in movies, I do want it to be in commercials, but I only want that if I own it." She continued on and explained that, quote, "It'll feel like regaining a freedom and taking back what's mine. When I created these songs, I didn't know what they would grow up to be. Going back in and knowing that it meant something to people is actually a really beautiful way to celebrate what the fans have done for my music." And with so many issues with how the music industry works, the question that's been on a lot of our minds is if Taylor has considered just starting her own music label at some point in the future so she can have more control on the business side of the process. And Billboard asked just about that. Her response was that, quote, "I do think about it every once in a while, but if I was going to do it, I would need to do it with all of my energy. I know how important that is when you've got someone else's career in your hands, and I know how it feels when someone isn't generous." But regardless of if she starts her own label or not, Taylor is still hoping to advocate for young artists, especially women, when it comes to speaking out and fighting for what they deserve. Taylor talked about how she feels a responsibility to use her platform to be the voice for others who don't have quite as much sway and power. She said, quote, "New artists and producers and writers need work, and they need to be likable and get booked in sessions. And they can't make noise, but if I can, then I'm going to. I know that it seems like I'm very loud about this, but it's because someone has to be." But this isn't the first time that Taylor has stood up for other artists. She's made it part of her life's work over this past decade. From 2014 to 2017, Taylor took her entire catalogue off of Spotify to protest the streaming company's compensation rates. Back in 2014, she said, quote, There should be an inherent value placed on art. I didn't see that happening perception-wise when I put my music on Spotify. In 2015, before the launch of Apple Music, Taylor wrote an open letter criticizing Apple for its plan to not pay royalties during the 3-month free trial it was supposed to offer listeners. And Taylor made a difference because Apple actually announced a new policy within 24 hours. And most recently, last year when Taylor signed a new deal with Universal Music Group, she said that one of the conditions of her contract was that UMG share proceeds from any sale of its Spotify equity with its entire roster of artists. So yeah, she's clearly looking out for others, and young artists are really lucky to have someone like Taylor who's paved the way for them and allowed them to use their voice. She talked about how she's happy to speak up for them when they can't. And I completely understand and respect Taylor for that. And honestly, I'm just so glad she is getting the recognition she deserves for the last decade of work. And we can't wait to see what she does in the next decade, am I right? And you know what? The next decade is just about to kick off, and I cannot wait to see what she's got in store. But right now, you guys, I want to know what you think. What was your favorite part of Taylor's Billboard interview? And also, do you think she will start her own label eventually? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And while you're down there leaving comments, you guys, it is like the perfect day to hit that subscribe button if you haven't before. I'll give you a few seconds. I kind of know where to go. I can just like hang out here for a little while. Cool. And also hit the bell to be notified the second we post a new Clevver News update. And after that, you can catch up on all the news you missed right over here. I'm Susan Morad. Thanks for hanging out with me, and I will see you later. Bye, guys.